concentration once after some time. And the thing is that I would have been very happy if this could have been an interactive class.
Make it interactive.
Yeah, so let's make it interactive. HelpAge India. So the name suggests itself that the aged, we are helping the aged people in India. Although it is an international organization, it's a federation of organization for the senior citizen. Like there's HelpAge International, there's HelpAge Bangladesh, Kenya, and so on. But HelpAge India is quite a robust organization compared to other international organizations affiliated to HelpAge International because of our very robust fundraising. And it is all public money, it is all accountable, and we have our own system of raising funds. Although in India, fundraising is a taboo. Now the topic, every year, it is for the entrepreneurship of NGOs. But there are two things. One, the NGO itself is an entrepreneur. The other, it helps people to build something on their own as a matter of livelihood. Now, 60 plus is the official old age here in India. So what do you think, anybody, that an elderly person can do as entrepreneurship? What should they first do? Is it individual, group, any just random thoughts? Any thought is all right, any suggestion is all right. It's not a test, no correct or right things. So please participate. If you need the mic, I can hand this over to you. So anyone from that corner? What entrepreneurship can be done by people who are... Yes.
Hi, friends, there are a lot of businesses with old people working and transmitting what they can do to younger people, like teaching them how to cook or teaching them...
Yeah, so that everybody can hear.
Okay, in France there are a lot of businesses where old people teach young people what they can do, like cooking, sewing, I don't know what else, but their traditions and everything, and so they give cooking classes, for example, and so that the generation, the old generation can be together.
So that's a social, generations can be together. So that is a social issue being addressed. Anybody else, any other suggestion? Did everybody hear what was said? Yeah, okay. Anybody else? Do you want to come from the dear, anybody to volunteer? Any other volunteers for any other suggestions? You wanted to say something, Anthony? Yeah.
Yeah, that's over here. Yeah. They can work as an advisory in any form of whatever work experience they have. They can go to any companies and lend their experiences. Let's say if there is a retired advocate, he can give his experience to a law firm in that.
Okay, so that is gainful occupation, something for their own individual livelihood. But when we are talking about entrepreneurship, that means that, you know, there are more people involved in it. And whatever livelihood or whatever their earnings, economically, it has to be sustainable. So, any other, if you think on those lines, any other suggestions?
Oh, brother, if I may.
Huh?
If I may.
Yes, sir.
Can I say something? Okay, my view on the matter is of course, what our friend said, and I'll add to it. He talked about elderly people contributing in legal practice or other things. And that's very important because if you take Calcutta High Court, I'm just making the same point, but I have a second point. But you have lawyers who are 80 plus, and there are a lot of people going to them because they feel they have far better experience, knowledge, whatever. Same goes for chartered accountants. Many of them, you know, continue well beyond their prime. This holds good for other kinds of advisory, because people, while the official retirement age is 60, nowadays there are lots of people who stay well or in a position to work well beyond that. You know, so actual retirement can happen much beyond 60. in a place like I am today, the retirement age in the last 20 years has been pushed and pushed and pushed. So you have people retiring much later. But quite apart from those statistics, I have something else to say, which is as the mindset of the, let's say, the middle class people is changing. In government jobs, let's say you retire at 60. You don't have a choice. Many in public sector and in government. But you still may be very passionate to do certain things. Okay? I'll give you one example. This is a case we will do later in the course, and I think some of my Indian friends might have done it in some other course. Look at Aravind Eye Hospital, the largest eye care provider of the world. They are basically a social enterprise. Okay. There, the gentleman basically retired from service and then set up the 11-bed clinic, which grew to become the largest network eye care provider in the world. So that is a living example of a person doing it, because somehow in India, we have this concept that as long as you have a secure job, you don't think of these lines. So there are places now that, of course, the numbers are very small, but while Aravind Eye Hospital may be a very large experiment, I think more and more people you will find these days retiring, particularly from government service, and then because they feel they might have earned enough, that they are looking at social ventures, social enterprises, sometimes even business ventures, to be able to group other people and move ahead, because we stay healthy for longer. So if you say the dividing the criteria for a senior citizen is 60, then there is a bracket I'm finding that between 60 and 70, there are a lot of people who have time to contribute.
Yeah. If I take it up from here, 60, I said officially you are a senior citizen, so you get certain benefits from the government, like pension. So I'll come to that later. And about, there are three kinds of division. One is young old. So at 60, you call them young old. So that is 60 to 70. 70 to 80 is old old. And 80 plus is very old. But my father is still alive. He's 95 years old. So he's above 90. So that is very old.
But didn't the World Health Organization revise these figures of late?
Yeah, they did. But what I'm saying, young old, old old and very old is there still. But what HealthAge has done is, young old at the age of 60 doesn't necessarily mean that person is physically or mentally fit. So we have said active aged people can be 75, even 80 year old people. Assisted meaning somebody has a is blind. We call it removable blindness because it's because of cataract. Now, when that cataract operation is done, that person can see, is once more independent, can go back to their livelihoods, and so on. So, assisted is we assist. We meaning HealthAge India. Whenever I'm talking we, I'm talking about our organization HealthAge India. They may do free operations, especially for the people who are below poverty line, and in urban, both urban and rural, for the urban and rural poor. So they get back their eyesight. Assisted is also for hearing aids, for a crutch, for a walker. So if we give them these things, they can be active once again. So active aging, assisted agent and destitute agent. Destitute is those who do not have anyone. Now, when we are thinking about entrepreneurship, one is that those who are professionals, as Mr. Mitter said, that they're professionals, so doctor, lawyers, other professionals, chartered accountants, they can go on as long as their mind and body is fit for them to go. Even if body is not fit, as long as their mind is fit, they can go along. But for those who are teachers as well, those who are in the service, they have a retirement age. And that retirement age from 60, in our organization, in fact, there should not have been any retirement age, but there is. From 60, it has been 62. Now there are some places where there is 65, so retirement age is also being increased. Now, when I'm talking about entrepreneurship with NGOs, I would also like you to think that there are 100 million senior citizens in India. 50 million of them are below poverty line and in the villages. So when we talk about livelihood, we think of those people who are in the villages with whom we have formed self-help groups. And self-help groups were always there, but nobody thought of elder self-help group, because the perception is that when a person becomes old, that person is unable to, he or she is unable to do any activity. So that is where help has stepped in, formed groups, and those groups are not only for livelihood, but they also knew how to, what were their rights. We are talking about child rights, this is elder rights. Because there are certain government welfare schemes and which they are unaware of. So when we form them into groups, they could go to the local panchayat, which is a kind of self-government, local self-government, and they could ask them or demand them from them their rights, which is roti kapra makan, as Professor Mitter said. This is shelter, food, and roti kapra and clothes. So these are the three basic things. Now, I will show you two short films. Like, one is, there was, you all of you know about the tsunami. I think that was in 2006. And after that, how a village which was completely washed away, we helped them in, we call it DRR, Disaster Relief and Rehabilitation, and where these fishermen, they were mostly fishermen because it was coastal area, and they were formed into groups, and how they started building up their lives, started reconstructing once again, and not only that, that became a very successful elder self-help group, which again started from each village, 10 or 15 groups from a village, and they were federated, and today the federation can support others. So from there we came to the elder for elder concept. And if you think of the older people, they are not a homogeneous group. You know, there are all kind of active elders, as I said, assisted elders, destitute elders, the poor, okay, the rich, the urban, the rural. So there are all kinds of elderly people, and each of their problems are different. In the city, if you have money, if you have everything, you do not have company, you are lonely. So that is a different issue with the elders. But we are talking about entrepreneurship, and I will show you what Helpage India has done as a part of entrepreneurship. And I believe after this presentation, you have to do a project on this. If you choose to do something for Helpage, then entrepreneurship designing is not possible to be for all practical purposes, because then you have to go for a village immersion. You have to stay in the village, understand the place, its economy, the geography, the kind of people who are there. So it's a kind of socio-economic factors which you have to be aware of before you can draw up any business plan for them. So, but what you can do is that you can visit our website and see what it looks like, and then have a different kind of a separate website design for livelihood. We also, it is all public money and donation because we are an NGO. So you can make a site for us where it will be interesting and nice and attractive, so that people can, and very easy to use, so that people can use it. And
you
those
put
who
these up on a, you've given it to me, haven't you?
No.
The topics of the assignments you have
proposed. Topic of the, I only said that because I have been coming here for several years now, and there are many students who have gone to the village for one or two days, they liked it, but you know, for them to understand it and sort of internalize it, and then to give a kind of a business plan on that is very difficult.
No, no, what I'm saying is website design, whatever.
No, I had said, yeah, I just said that they can give a website designing as
no,
a part
no,
of the
you
course.
Said that. You mail me anything on this, because then I'll upload it onto the courseware.
No, I asking
you
who are
main. You uploaded suggested assignment, so if you could just send
it. I have sent it to you.
If you have sent it, then it's already there.
This is what I had suggested.
Okay, so then it's there. So it's
okay.
There.
So the thing is, I will show you two short films on what we did. One is tsunami and how they after that they rebuild their lives, and that is what entrepreneurship in the villages. This is a village in South India near the coast, and after that I'll show you another film which is in here in Bengal.
Space.
Tiny grains of hope and a lifetime of hard work, they built their homes. Only to lose it all in a moment of nature's furious rage. This was when the 2004 tsunami struck and swept away countless lives and hopes. Amrita Valli from Kadalur was one among them. For her, it was not just about the struggle of building life and livelihood all over again, but also about a sense of pain and overwhelming loss. Nature took away everything from Amrita Valli. For Chinnapun, her own children took away her sense of security, her family and home. 2,000 kilometers from Katlore in Tamil Nadu, Kishan Mehta lives in village Supol in Bihar. A bonded laborer all his life, Kishan Mehta lost his only home, his son, in an accident. All he was left with was a small piece of farmland that wasn't enough to sustain him. India has 100 million senior citizens today. 15 million live alone. 71 million have to work to survive. Sidelined, often abused through neglect and isolation, these elders live lonely, impoverished, and almost invisible lives. It is towards this vulnerable population that HelpAge India directs its resources in order to provide them with income and a self-sufficient life. HelpAge organizes them into viable and sustainable Elder Self-Help Groups, or ESHGs. The elders in the group pool their resources to support each other. Kishan Mehta is now a member of Kushwaha Elder Self-Help Group.
Kishan Mehta बहुत गरीब आदमी है, हम समूह की ओर से इनका जो मासिक बचत है वो हम लोग ही करेंगे, लेकिन उसको निकाल को निकालने नहीं देंगे।
With the group, Kishan is not just living again, but redefining the meaning of living with dignity.
समूह के पास सब चीज के लिए कभी सब की बात हो, जेमे के नून के रहे खर्चा पर बहुत बीमारी, डॉक्टरों खोल करके समूह के द्वारा फ्री इलाज.
In Kadalur, the Tamarai Elders Self-Help Group has enabled Amrita Valli to build a profitable dry fish vending business. The Elders for Elders Foundation and ESHG helped Chinnakundu start a small fruits and nuts vending business. Of elders need special support to match the productivity of younger groups. Besides providing an extra push with funding and special training, HelpAge India facilitates their federation at the local and district levels. The these ESHG members were trained in vermin composting by a local agriculture university and qualified to secure the initial funds from Grameen Bank.
This type of vermin pit manual is all upon upon Udrahma vermin pit manaka had manaka betwo karita upon Keto Medece, Hamu de Chia, Akna Ketu, Sir Alaba, Pahar, Kil Padi Gadece.
In addition, HelpAge India strives to spread awareness of various government entitlements and of the mechanisms of receiving these by the village elderly.
खुशियाली यहाँ पर समूह के माध्यम से खुशियाली बहुत तरह से है व्यवसाय कर रहा है जैसे कपड़ा सिलाई कर रहा है दो ठो पंप सेट समूह के माध्यम से दिए हैं पांच ठो सिलाई मशीन दिए हैं
Members of this ESHG in Chanjarpur, Bihar went all the way to the collector of their area to lease a farm. With it, they have now developed an integrated and sustainable fish farming system. Are singing a whole new song in a chorus of hope. HelpAge India is currently working closely with more than 5,394 rural elder self-help groups in different states, and these numbers are constantly on the rise. They now know that together they will not just survive, but would emerge as winners. Enlightened donors such as you can support more such groups and put this song of hope on the lips of countless needy elders.
Universal pension. How much time is there?
minutes.
Another 10 minutes?
15 minutes.
Okay, so I will show you another film. I can fast forward to some portions of it. This is in rural Bengal. This is again entrepreneurship with what we do as HelpAge India is we form them into self-help groups and then we provide for a sustainable livelihood. So that when we come out of that place,
HelpAge India is a little check.
Go on with it themselves.
Charity platform established in 1978 works with and for disadvantaged elderly. It works in the following areas like elderly rights, elder care and supporters. HelpAge India supports the elderly in many parts of West Bengal and covers its program known as Elder Self-Help Group Program. One of such places is Purulia. Purulia is a district located in West Bengal, is rich with culture and natural beauty. HelpAge India supports the villagers by focusing on their program of Elder Self-Help Group. We, with the support of HelpAge, covered some of the villages and gained lots of experiences. We mainly focused on Morguma and Begumkodo village. People here have their group meetings once in a week and start it with a prayer song, and here they keep records of the interlending of money done. Bring a handful of rice and gathers it for the destitute. They depend on their livelihood like goats, cows, pigs, etc.
তোমার নাম কি?
ডাবলং
রায়। ছাগল আছে বাড়িতে?
আছে।
ছাগল চাষের মানে তোমার কি হিসেব? মানে এরা বলছে ছাগল চাষ করা থেকে লাভ থেকে ক্ষতি থেকে কি লাভ হয় কি ক্ষতি হয়?
লাভ অনেক নেই। এখন আপাতত ছাগল কিনেছি আমি প্রথম একটা।
আচ্ছা।
এখন আছে আটটা।
In a more better way.
These are meetings. They have meeting, weekly meeting. When each member of self-help group they contribute. And they come up with any, if they have any problem, they come up with that. And then they go together.
Government meetings and camps takes place in the village panchayats to give some knowledge to the villagers about.
Anyway, if you are going alone, this is the theory of one stick and a bundle of a bunch of sticks. If you are going, you can break one stick very easily. So if you are going alone, nobody will hear you, the government officials. But if you are going in a group, then they are bound to listen to you. So with that concept, these elder self-help groups, not only the livelihood and financial transaction goes on, but they are also made aware of their rights and how to demand their rights from the government.
About how to maintain and improve their livelihood activities. The groups even have their names like Basunti, Parvati, Durga, etc. And the members of each group are very responsible and takes care of the needs of